Today we're going to be taking a look at the SportRack Tilting Single Mast Design 3 Bike Rack. This part number is SR2703. The SportRack is designed to tilt away from your vehicle. All we have to do is simply pull the pin and clip located here at the bottom and tilt it away from the vehicle. As you can see, it's got a real low area here, so for most of your SUVs, this shouldn't pose a problem when we're opening the rear hatch. Once that slow door gets closed, we'll bring the rack back up. We're just gonna slide the pin back in. Here on the other side, we'll take our clip and slide it in to secure it in that position. We've got three very nice cradles. The third one back is locking, so we'll have that last bike locked onto the rack so that these can't be removed. The locking knobs are going to come, or you can loosen it up, and then we just rotate this down. It's going to allow us to bring up the upper portion of our clamp. Now we've got four different positions here at the rear that we can choose from for our clamp. This will allow us to go even down to the smallest tubes of bikes, all the way up to a full 2.5-inch tube. As you can see inside, we've got the grooves in here, top and bottom. That's going to help accommodate any of the brake lines or cables. And it's a nice soft rubber material. It's going to protect that bike's frame from scratches. As we bring it down, it's going to give us a nice four-corner contact to really firmly secure the bike into our rack for us. Now the material itself, sturdy steel, they put a nice gray powder coat finish. That's going to help resist the rust and the corrosion that we might get. And they also offer a limited lifetime warranty on their product. Now that we've gone over most of the key features of the rack, let's go ahead and show you how to install it on your vehicle. Before we install it, I want to talk to you about the shank of the rack. As you can see, for any 1¼-inch use, we've got a nice solid steel shank there. It's going to give us good, dependable use. Once we go up to the 2-inch, we're just going to place on the sleeve. No bolts required, no screws to put it on there. Very simple process there. And then we'll just slide it into the receiver tube of the hitch. Now, depending on the way your hitch is set up, we've got two different holes to choose from here. I like getting it as far away from the vehicle as I can, so I'm just going to use that first one. So we're going to line whichever hole we decide to use up with our hitch pin hole. With those in line, we'll take our anti-rattle bolt, which is provided, and thread that in. Now this anti-rattle bolt, once we have it tightened in there, it's going to pull the rack right over against the edge of the receiver tube. That's going to keep it from moving up and down and side to side and really give our bikes a good firm ride without a bunch of vibration. Once we have it hand tight, we're just going to tighten it down with a wrench. As you can see, once you've got it tight, this connection point's not moving without the vehicle moving. We'll then take our supplied clip, slide it in here on the other side of the end of our bolt, just to give us a second level of security there. Loading up our bikes, a simple task. We're gonna loosen up our black T-handle, allow that to fold back, and then we'll take off the top part of our clamp. We'll then grab our bike, place it right up into the cradle. We're gonna use the lowest position that we can and still effectively secure our bike in here. Then we'll loosen that T-handle. I should have loosened it up a little more initially, but there you go. That's going to come over the top. Then we just tighten it down. As you can see, this is a carbon fiber framed bike, and we've got really no issues with any of the pressure since it is applied nice and evenly over the whole surface. And once we've got that secure, as you can see, it really holds our bike into position there. Now we'll go ahead and load up a couple more bikes to get it to capacity. As you can see here, we've mounted up our woman's frame style bike. Now with a woman's frame, a kid's frame, or a hybrid frame, We recommend using a bike adapter bar. SportRack has one available. Its part number is SR0500. That's just gonna alleviate us putting the cradle underneath the bike and really getting it way up higher than what the other bikes are. Now, some mountain bikes also have, and it's not quite as exaggerated as this one, but they'll have a top bar that'll kind of slope down a little bit too. SportRack's designed in a solution for that. I'll show you quickly how that works. We'll place our bike right up into our cradle. As you can see here, I've already removed one of the covers, but we'll remove the second one. And currently, our bike is tilted with the rear wheel up. As you can see, this is much higher than the other two wheels. So we want to bring this down. As you can see, this one's about even. It's a little bit lower than the other one, so we want to bring that one up. Adjusting is as easy as removing the two black covers that cover our nuts here. This is attached to a U-bolt that runs around to the underside. We're just gonna loosen these up a little bit. And as you can see, that cradle is gonna adjust to whatever angle we decide we want it at. Let's see here. Now that to me looks much more level. Looks like we're gonna have a nice secure ride there. So I'll just keep a hand on the bike. And then we'll tighten these two bolts back down. Now you can use a wrench, a socket, you know, whatever you've got around the house. Even a crescent wrench is gonna work fine. The one I'm using here is a 14 millimeter. So you keep that in mind if you are gonna pack a wrench in the car with you or something. But the good thing about this is once you've got them set for each individual bike, you won't really have to worry about it unless you're switching out and bringing a friend's bike or something like that along. Then we're just gonna follow that same process that we used on the other two. Bring the top part of our cradle up and around. We're gonna loosen up our knob. Now, as you can see, this is a locking knob. Really gonna secure your bikes into place. The way it works is that when it's unlocked, it's actually gonna turn and tighten to reach down and grab that bike and secure it. Once we switch it into the locked position, place our key in, rotate it, it actually goes into a free spool mode. So it's not gonna loosen, it's not gonna tighten. The great thing about that is, if somebody comes up and tries to just kind of grab hold of it and put a lot of torque on it and break a lock or break a little catch that's inside some of them, they're not gonna be able to do it. It's just gonna free spin, it's not gonna give them the force they need to break that lock. Once we've got our cradle set the way we've want it, we're just gonna take our black caps and place them right back over the heads of those nuts to keep them protected and out of the elements. The bike rack has a total weight capacity of 132 pounds. That will complete today's look at the SportRack Tilting 3 Bike Rack designed for both 1¼ and 2-inch hitches. Part number SR2703.